So Nia, welcome.
Thank you.
Nice to see you. So first of all, can we talk about the title to My Big Fat Greek Wedding 2? It's the obvious title to go with, but were there any other options when you were first writing this?
No, I wanted to reclaim our title because after My Big Fat Greek Wedding 1, all of a sudden I was quite flattered that there were My Big Fat This and My Big Fat That. There were a lot of shows in the United States and Canada that used the title. And I didn't mind. I just thought, oh, that's interesting. But then people thought I was affiliated with these things, and I was not. So I thought, you know what? Let's take our title back. So My Big Fat Greek Wedding 2.
And I know it was quite a long time coming as well. And I've read various interviews about why you decided to wait so long. But it's basically because you wanted to experience motherhood yourself before you could write that for your character. Is that right?
There was just no way I could do it. I didn't know anything that apparently Tula and Ian would be feeling. You know, at the end of the first one, I had written that we were parents, but in reality, I was not. Then I was very suddenly a mom, and on my daughter's first day of kindergarten, somebody said something because I was crying so hard. I think she was trying to calm me down, and she said, oh, come on, in 13 years, they'll leave us and go off to college. And I was like, leave us? What on earth are you talking about? And I realized that my reaction was so violent in that my throat closed and I broke out in a sweat. And I thought, oh, my God, I have morphed into my own suffocating parents. I am my own parents. And that's when I got the idea for the sequel, to write what I know once again.
And we know that the first one was written a lot from your own experience, too. So this one, did you not mind sharing with the world that you maybe are a bit suffocating as a parent?
I'm slightly embarrassed, but I think this will be therapy for me to let go. I actually give my scripts to my mom to read before. My mom is the arbiter of good taste in our family because, you know, I really do have an Aunt Vula with a lump on the back of her neck that she claims is her twin.
I love Aunt Vula as like one of my favorite characters of all time. Like, is she the most fun to write because she's back in the sequel and has probably some of the best, most funny lines?
Thank you for saying that, because they're all a joy to write for. I hear them in my head when I'm alone in my office. I said sometimes, you know, I had 14 characters to write for at all times. I said sometimes I could see Joey Fatone, who plays Cousin Angelo, sitting on the corner of my desk going, you know, I haven't spoken since page 35, huh? Aunt Vula is for me the most fun because she's like my alter ego. She's a little bit dirty. She's a little bit mischievous.
What sort of things do most people quote back at you? Because you must have got this for the past decade.
I hear, put some Windex on it, even from my own gynecologist. That's a moment. I hear, hey, big fat Greek girl, when I'm walking down the street.
Nice.
Hey, Ian, we're going to kill you, quite often. Yeah.
Is there anything that the first film gave you? Because it obviously gave a lot to your life and changed your life quite dramatically. But anything unwanted from it, from that success?
There's no day off from being a known person. So I had to make that adjustment. And the only time that I have boundaries is when I'm with my daughter. But people are amazing. Like, when we go to Disneyland or even just to the shopping mall, if someone approaches for a picture and I say, well, we're having a family day, people immediately understand that and go, oh, all right. I shake their hands and I say, if I ever meet you again, I owe you a picture. A woman ran up to me in the Dallas airport and said, you owe me a picture. I was like, okay, fair enough. Fair enough.
I know that this one is already getting really good reviews, which is what you want. So a threequel is being planned. Is that correct?
Well, I haven't started writing it yet. Just a little bit of it. I can't help it.
So you have started writing it.
A little bit, yes.
I know that last year you did the Great Holiday Bake Off, which is taken from a British format.
Uh-huh.
You got to work with Mary Berry, who's quite an institution over here. How was Mary to work with?
Mary is the real deal. This is my how I would really explain Mary Berry. She has such a strong constitution and a good work ethic. We were in the marquee, and we were doing the bake-off, and it was raining, and the wind was blowing the rain into the back of the marquee, into our necks, and the back of our clothes were completely soaked. So on a break, I turned around, and I said, oh, that's a tent. Does that close? And they said, oh, yeah. So they closed it, and Mary said, oh, I never realized that closed. She would never dream of complaining.